हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी मावर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर जूलॉजी, श्री सांवरिया जी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, मंडफिया, चित्तौड़गढ़। टुडे माय टॉपिक इज क्लोनिंग व्हीकल, व्हिच इज़ अ वन ऑफ द टूल्स ऑफ जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग। क्लोनिंग वेक्टर, क्लोनिंग वेक्टर इज अ डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल व्हिच हैज़ द एबिलिटी टू रेप्लिकेट इन एन host cell and into which the DNA fragments to be cloned known as DNA insert is integrated for cloning. Vectors are the DNA molecule which can carry a foreign DNA fragments to be cloned and they are self-replicating in an appropriate host cell. So for to act as vector DNA molecule, vector should be qualities or characteristics. First is that ideal vector should be small in size. It should have a single restriction endonucleus site. It should have an ORI, that is origin of replication. It should have one or two genetic markers which are used to identify recipient cells carrying vectors. Some important vectors are plasmids, bacteriophages, cosmids, phasmids, YAC vector and BAC vector. So first is plasmid. Plasmids are circular, extra chromosomal, double-stranded, self-replicating DNA molecule. Almost all the bacteria have a plasmid, which contain a low copy number, that is 1 to 4 per cell of plasmid, or a high copy number, 10 to 100 plasmid per cell. The size of plasmid varies from 1 to 500 kb. Plasmid contributes to about 0.5 to 5.0% of the total DNA of the bacteria. They are characteristics like they can replicate or duplicate autonomously. They may pick up genes from one bacteria and transfer them to another bacteria. They retain their characters after combining with DNA of another organism, and they are not main part of genome of bacteria, and that's why a plasmid can be easily isolated in a large quantities and they can be transferred easily. There are types of plasmid. First is F plasmid. It possesses gene for their own transfer from one cell to another and which is responsible for conjugation. Then R plasmid, it carries genes resistance to antibiotics. Then Col plasmid, it code for colchicine, and which is a protein that kills sensitive E. coli cells. There are also conjugative and non-conjugative plasmids. Conjugative plasmids are large and they show stringent control of DNA replication and they are present in low numbers, while non-conjugative plasmids are small, they show relaxed control of DNA replication and they are present in high numbers. There is a nomenclature of plasmid. So plasmid is designated by lowercase p, which is followed by first letter of researcher names and the numerical number given by the workers. See, PBR322. So P means plasmid, BR means researcher, that is Bolivar and Rodriguez, and the number given by the worker is 322. So PBR322. P means plasmid, BR means Bolivar and Rodriguez, and the number given by worker is 322. It is a most common plasmid vector of E. coli. It is most popularly and widely used plasmid vector and is appropriately regarded as the parent or the grandparent of several other vectors. PBR322 has a DNA sequence of 4361 base pair. 4361 base pair. It carries genes resistance for ampicillin and tetracycline that serve as a marker for the identification of clones carrying plasmid. The plasmid has a recognition sites for the action of restriction endonuclease, such as EcoRI, HindThird, BMHI, SAIL, SAIL, and PST. Second, it is EcoRI first, it is a HindThird, it is BMH first, this is SAI first, and this is a PST second. So here you can see there is a recognition site for the action of restriction endonuclease. This is EcoRI or EcoR first, HindThird, BMH1, SAL1, this is PSTL1. So these are the sites for the restriction endonuclease. Now bacteriophages. Bacteriophages, or we can simply say phages, they are the virus that replicate within the bacteria. In case of certain phages, their DNA gets incorporated into the bacterial chromosome and remains there permanently. Phage vectors can accept short fragment of foreign DNA into their genomes. The advantage with phage is that they can take up larger DNA segments than plasmids. Hence, phage vectors are preferred for working with genome of human cell. So types of phages or bacteriophages are bacteriophage lambda and phage M30. Bacteriophage lambda, or simply phage lambda, is a virus of E. coli. It consists of a head and a tail, and both are made up of protein, and their shape is comparable to a miniature hypodermic syringe. The DNA is located in their head, and the DNA is a linear molecule of about 50 kV. At each end of the DNA, there are single-stranded extension of 12 base length each, which have a coercive ends. On attachment with the tail to E. coli, phage injects its DNA into the cell. Inside E. coli, the phage linear DNA cyclicizes and gets ligated through coarse ends to form a circular DNA. The phage DNA has two phases. It may be lytic cycle or lysogenic cycle. Then phage M13 vector. Phage M13, that is bacteriophage M13, is a single-stranded DNA phage of E. coli. And inside the host cell, M13 synthesizes a complementary strand which forms double-stranded DNA. That is a replicative form of DNA, rfDNA. For use as a vector, rfDNA is isolated and foreign DNA can be inserted on it, which is then returned to the host cell as a plasmid. Single-stranded DNA are recovered from phage particle. M13 is useful for sequencing DNA through Sanger's method. So these are the types of bacteriophages, or simply phages. Then cosmids. Cosmids are the vectors which possess characteristics of both plasmid and bacteriophage lambda. They are constructed by combining certain feature of plasmid and co-sites of phage lambda. They are very attractive for constructing libraries of DNA fragments of eukaryotes because they have a capacity to accommodate a large fragment of DNA. The recombinant DNA, which is formed, can be packed as a phages and injected into E. coli. And once inside the host cell, cosmid behaves like a plasmid and starts replicating. Cosmid has an origin of replication and selectable markers and a gene cloning sites of plasmid DNA. But cosmid lack structural and regulatory gene of lambda DNA. The advantage of using cosmid is that they can carry large fragments of foreign DNA, which is compared to plasmid. So a foreign DNA like about 14 KB can be inserted into cosmid DNA. Now phagids are the combination of plasmid and phage DNA, and they can function as either one, that is a plasmid or phage. Phagids possess functional origin of replication of both plasmid and phage lambda, and hence they can be propagated in appropriate E cell as a plasmid or phage. The vector phagids may be used in many ways in a cloning experiments. So this type of plasmid vectors contain a fragment of phage DNA including its ATT site. Now vector, it is YAC. Its full form is yeast artificial chromosome. They are used to clone DNA fragments of more than 2500 MB in size, and they are used in mapping large genome like human genome project. Then BAC vector, that is a bacterial artificial chromosomes. So these are the cloning vector, plasmids, bacteriophages, cosmids, and phagids, YAC and BAC vector, BAC vector. So plasmids are circular double-stranded DNA molecule which occur as a extra chromosomal state and self-replicating. Then phages or bacteriophages, which may be lambda phage or M13 phage. Then cosmids, which are constructed by combining certain features of plasmid and cos sites of phage lambda, and they are used for constructing libraries of DNA fragment of eukaryotes because they can accommodate large fragment of DNA. Then phagids are a type of plasmid vectors which contain a fragment of phage DNA which includes its ATT site. Then YAC vectors means yeast artificial chromosome. They are used to clone DNA fragments of more than 2500 MB in size. They are used in mapping large genome project like human genome project, BAC, bacterial artificial chromosomes. There are some more vector like shuttle vector and transposons. So these are about cloning vector. Actually, these clones are used to form a millions or billions copies of a gene, which includes the isolation and lifting of a fragment of DNA from one source and introducing into a cell within where it is amplified, and the cell is also multiplied, and the result is a sizable quantity of a pure sample of lifted piece of DNA or gene. So these vectors are very useful for gene cloning. Now how can we choose vector? So size of the foreign DNA is very important while we choose vectors. So the efficiency of this process is often crucial for determining the success of gene cloning. The size of the DNA insert that can be accepted by different vectors is mentioned over here. So phase lambda, E. coli is host, foreign DNA which can be inserted into it is 5 to 25 kb. If vector is cosmid lambda, then host is E. coli, then foreign insert DNA is 35 to 45 kb. There is also plasmid artificial chromosome like YAC. So if the host is E. coli, then 100 to 300 kb foreign DNA can be inserted into it. Bacterial artificial chromosome BAC, host is E. coli, and 100 to 300 kb foreign DNA can be inserted into it. Then yeast chromosome, if and the host is S. cerevisiae, so 200 to 2000 kb foreign DNA can be inserted into it. Thank you.